Hello friends, welcome back to another episode by Engineering Today, and we're back with some interesting space updates. We'll start with an update where SpaceX is on the way to test out B7.1 tanks, followed by an exciting news from New Zealand, and we'll wrap up with an update from China. Let's get started with SpaceX on how to test the B7.1 tank very soon. On June 16th, SpaceX teams rolled a second test tank to the launch site. The second tank came to be known as B7.1. The tank joined with the E-Dome tank at a place which was earlier used as a Starship landing pad. As per reports, the E-Dome tank is a generic one for tank tests, but tank B7.1 is specifically designed to test super heavy booster design changes. Rolling out B7.1 came nearly a week after rolling of E-Dome from its South Texas Starship factory to nearby launch and test facilities. SpaceX is presently focused on preparing their Starship S-24 and Super Heavy B-7 for upcoming static fire tests that could eventually result in pairing of the duo to carry out the first orbital flight test. Sources state that the E-Dome tank's purpose is much more generic in terms of tests. In E-Dome, the steel rings appear similar to the ones used in present Starship and Super Heavy prototypes. But on the other hand, the E-Dome's two domes are different from the several domes that SpaceX has built and tested over the last 3 years of their Starship development phase. According to some reports, the new domes are less complex and easier to construct than the earlier ones. Moreover, due to their extra spherical shape, they can easily carry some more propellant in the tanks while taking up the same amount of vertical space, increasing their efficiency. Reports say that B7.1 is almost a smaller version of Super Heavy. The three-ring top section of B7.1 is nearly identical to the top section of a Super Heavy booster, and it's strengthened with numerous external stringers. The only difference which can be seen is that B7.1 has neither cutouts for grid fins, nor the tank's forward dome does have any reaction frame to install grid fins. At the bottom half of B7.1, the same strengthening stringers are present. Another feature which can be noted is that the tank has four slightly shorter rings into the same height in place of three rings. This tank also comprises a super heavy thrust dome of a new design that increases the number of central Raptor engines from 9 to 13. SpaceX rolled out the E-Dome tank on the 8th of June, but after passing of more than a week, SpaceX doesn't appear to go for any sort of tests on E-Dome. Report says that SpaceX will use these tanks to test those significant design changes which are noticed in B7.1. Earlier in 2021, SpaceX teams have carried out a test of BN2.1 tank. BN2.1 is a thrust dome for 9 Raptors, which amounts to 1,700 tons of thrust. But in case of B7.1 tank, testing the 13 hydraulic rams will simulate 3,000 tons of thrust, as B7.1 is a thrust dome for 13 Raptors. Test of B7.1 will help SpaceX achieve a greater record as well as newer experiences. SpaceX regularly used test tanks to qualify significant design changes before applying those changes to full prototypes. This helps them reduce the amount of resource lost during any test of unproven prototype, but it's quite surprising that SpaceX have first completed assembly of Super Heavy Booster B7 with installation of 33 engines on it and almost completed another Super Heavy Booster B8. And later, they assembled a B7.1 test tank, which is meant to test the upgrades carried out in B7 as well as B8. This gives rise to a possibility that if B7.1 meets with failure during testing, then SpaceX will be forced to discard their two nearly finished Super Heavy boosters, which are similar to B7.1 in terms of upgrades. And it will ultimately result in wastage of months for assembly and testing and rendering of prototypes that are worth tens of millions of dollars. But some reports state, in a hopeful note, that Super Heavy Booster 7 may have already completed Raptor thrust simulation tests, and that too may be in a successful manner. So this leaves us to see what happens in the B7.1 test. If the B7.1 thrust simulation test is carried out well and good, then it will lead to further tests of Super Heavy boosters. On the other hand, failure will render B7 and B8 unusable or incapable of flight, ultimately delaying Starship's first orbital launch attempt. Let's move to our next news from New Zealand, as stargazers observing spiraling light formations on a recent Sunday night, New Zealand's sky was recently blessed with something truly magnificent. Pictures of this unusual image are currently being shared widely on social media. The images are being compared to some kind of wormhole by many New Zealanders, with the caption, "Does anyone know if there was a satellite put into orbit over New Zealand tonight, or maybe an Australian satellite? Saw something like the picture I posted at about 1920 hours tonight, looking slightly west at a high elevation, Rangoria, Canterbury." User Inch Justin posted the startling image to the Facebook group Astronomy in New Zealand. Additionally, Justin added that the image shared is merely an illustration of what he observed. "Fortunately, I was unable to capture a photo of it. Instead, I grabbed my binoculars and observed what appeared to be a satellite in the midst of the spiral traveling north at a high rate of knots." The blue skies in New Zealand were first captured by residents of the Nelson City in North Island. They were visible about 750 kilometers south to Stewart Island. As per a physicist at Auckland University, Professor Richard Easter, such clouds are usually spotted when a rocket carried a satellite into orbit. On Sunday morning, SpaceX launched a Falcon 9 rocket carrying a Globalstar DM-15 satellite. This was the third rocket launch in the previous 36 hours. The rocket spun and discharged fuel as it delivered its payload, creating a vapor trail that reflected sunlight. The observable blue swirl was produced by the rocket's lighted exhaust. The eye-catching spiral was most likely caused by a fuel spill, according to the New Plymouth Astronomical Society. Let's wrap up with news from China. 2 years before a NASA and ESA combined effort, China's Mars Sample Return Mission seeks to gather samples from the Red Planet and return them to Earth in 2031. The Tianwen-1 Mars Orbiter and Rover Mission's chief designer, Sun Zhezhu, unveiled a new mission profile on June 20th. He described ideas for a two-launch profile that would launch in late 2028 and return samples to Earth in July 2031. With a single Mars landing and no rovers sampling separate sites, the complicated multi-launch mission will have a simpler design than the joint NASA-ESA project. However, if successful, it would bring the first samples of Mars to Earth, achieving a goal widely acknowledged as one of the main scientific objectives of space travel. A lander and ascent vehicle and an orbiter and return module will be the components of China's Tianwen-3 mission, respectively. Separate launches of the combinations will occur on Long March 5 and Long March 3B rockets, respectively. Another important detail is that the mission's expected landing in the Northern Hemisphere would occur around the autumnal equinox. Potential sandstorms and a lack of solar energy are two related challenges. Top space and government officials appear to be supporting China's Mars Sample Return Project. The country's desire to complete the groundbreaking mission has previously been acknowledged, and it was also outlined in the development goals for the China National Space Administration for the years 2021 to 2025. There will be two missions before the sample return: the nation's first independent interplanetary mission, Tianwen-1, which sent a rover and orbiter to Mars in July 2020, was launched. A main belt comet will also be visited by Tianwen-2, a mission to sample near-Earth asteroids. A 2025 launch is predicted per the current plans. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comments section. This will help us to improve.